time in my life where the holes in my socks were so big you could put them off my leg. I grew up in a tenement in New York. My mother, my father, and 11 kids, and 1.5 mothers. We had 2 beds and a cot. You had to take a number off the wall to go to sleep. The clothes we wore were made out of rag from the found on the streets, or a pair of curtains on the doorway. You know what it is for a young boy growing up in a tough neighborhood in East New York to wear curtains. Can you picture that? Fairies used to be pale. And for all the freezing winters and hot, hungry summers, for all the scrimping and scrubbing, for all the sickness without doctors, without medicine, one winter, we all had the whooping cough at the same time. 11 kids throwing up simultaneously in 1.5 rooms. My mother nursed us on roller skates. And through all the pain and the heartache and the suffering, she never complained or cried out against the world. Because she knew it was God's will. Whatever God gives you, God can take away. That was the lesson of this artist. And for whatever God has given you, be thankful. My mother never lived to enjoy my success. She died peacefully in her sleep on the BMT subway. Her last words to the conductor were, "If God wanted me to live, I would have taken the bus today." All I wanted for my wife and kids were no to suffer the way I did as a child. Not to be deprived of life's various necessities, but such wealth, such riches. I never asked for it. I never needed all of this. Every year I give half of what I earn to charity, and the next year I get twice as much. Wealth is as much a responsibility as poverty is a burden.